Welcome back, everyone. You are on with Caitlin from Banker Inc. Today, we're going to be discussing how to enter cash receipts under the AR module in Sage 100 Contractor. So first, let's open up our companies. We're going to open up the sample company today. That's going to be the primary one that we operate in. And on our left-hand side on our menu, we're going to navigate over to 331 cash receipts. From here, you'll be opening up to a record entry screen. And we're going to put in the cash receipt to post with the amount of the deposit that we're entering. So here, I'm going to select the ledger account that I want it to go into. Let's just say I'm going to put it in my general checking account. The deposit number will already pre-fill to the next available number, or you can override it and put in your own. This example, I'm going to leave it just as the sequence prompts me to. And I'm going to put in today's date, is 8/13 of 20. And my description, I can put in a couple items here, but for this example, I'm just going to put in cash receipt. Once I populate my account on this column here, it's going to put in the available balance for me on this box. So this is a grayed out. You can't override this. This comes straight from the general ledger. Now here is where you can do it for a specific client or job. You can search by those items as well. If you're entering deposits though for multiple jobs or multiple clients, leave this blank because it won't populate all of them. It'll only do a few items of that selection criteria. And then I'm going to hit display invoices. It's going to populate all the invoices that I have as of today's date available to pay on. Or I could do specifically for one client or specifically for one job. This will filter it down a little bit more. Notice how all of my defaults are open only. Now, if I need to go to all invoices, then I can select that one, hit display invoices, and it'll bring up more of a list for me. This is also divided up on contract invoices under the 3-5 jobs or service invoices if your company utilizes the service receivables module. So here there's a couple invoices that can be paid under the service receivables module or from the 3-5 job screen. Okay, so let's enter in just a cash receipt for something that we're needing to pay on. If I wanted to pay on this top item here, looks like this is a retention amount for a progress bill. Let's say I wanted to make this payment. I can put in the check number. I can do paid, and for this example, I'm going to just type in 95.69.34 for the balance of what I'm going to be depositing. If, for an example, I had one check that was to go for two payments, I will still do the same amount, same process here of entering in what was paid on that check. I can say this is check 100. Down here, it'll give me the total of my deposit, which this should match if they're giving you cash or a voucher or check. This should be the total amount that they are giving you. So this is a good way to check and make sure that your totals are equaling the same. If I wanted to see more details about this invoice, I can hit this invoice number in the column and hit drill down. It will take me straight to that invoice on my AR invoice and credit screen. That's a good way to kind of get more information on how you got to that amount that's due, and then if they are making a payment on that invoice. Once you've put in the amounts that you're depositing, you can hit the save button up here. Oh, for me, my sample company is never in the right period that I need it to be in. So I'm just gonna override that and say okay for this argument, and it should disappear and take you back to a new blank screen. If you want to try a new criteria method or selection, you can keep going with putting in cash receipts. So now those two invoices are paid, and if I was to repopulate my available invoices that are open, those two would not be on that list anymore. So pretty standard. The biggest way to go through that is to go to 331 and go through and put in the amounts that are paid for the check or the cash that they gave you. If you have any questions or want to talk further about this, how this can apply for your company, the best way to get in contact with me is to send me an email at coordinator@bangerinc.com or leave me a comment below and I can review that as well. If you like the content that we're producing, want to dive deeper, please stay tuned on our YouTube. We produce videos weekly, so do not forget to subscribe. Thanks, guys. See you later.